And the big story that is defining our news agenda. Days after he was captured, Pakistani terrorist Ali Babar has exposed his handlers. That's the big breaking news coming in at the moment. Ali Babar was captured by the army on 27th of September and has been giving crucial intelligence inputs on his terror group, Lashkar-e-Toiba. He's confessed on camera, on video, that he was directed by his handlers to enter India on 13th of September and that he was a part of a group of infiltrators. The terrorist also has gone ahead and exposed the Pakistani army and their role in unleashing terror in the valley. Babar on camera has also confirmed that he was trained by the Pakistani army.
तो मैं सब कुछ करा गया फैक्ट्री में अपना मिले का भाई तो उधर एक पास नाम लड़का था जो सब मैं पहुँच की थी तो उसको सब वो लश्कर करवा के लिए बाइक से कि बैठे करते करते काम कर रहा था तो मुझे वह नहीं पता था तो उसने ऐसा बात हुआ कि जो एस थी उसके पास पैसे भी दिल्ली साहब कह दिया तो मुझे पता कर दी जहाँ पर ले जा रहा हूँ तो मैं
Sunil ji Bhatt now joins us live for the very latest on this story. Sunil ji, this is a big win coming in for our security forces. Not only have they captured the terrorists, there is also a confession coming in. This will provide the right kind of intelligence that our Indian military establishment requires. What's interesting to note here, Sunil ji, is that the terrorist himself on camera has confirmed that he was trained by the Pakistani army.
Absolutely, Cheti, this Pakistani terrorist has dealt Islamabad's role in fomenting trouble in Jammu and Kashmir. And he is clearly saying that how Pakistan Army and the ISI are involved in anti-India activities. Cheti, it's not hidden something from the international community that Pakistan is the epicenter of terrorism. And in the recent past also, Pakistan has indulged in anti-India activities. It's training terrorists and it is sending terrorists to Jammu and Kashmir to create mayhem in Jammu and Kashmir. But this has come from the horse's mouth. This has come from a terrorist who has been trained by Pakistan Army and the ISI. He's clearly nailing the role of Islamabad. And we have seen, Cheti, that at the international forum, Pakistan plays the victim card and says that it's itself a victim of terrorism. But this video clearly exposes Pakistan that Pakistan is the epicenter of terrorism and it continues to train terrorists against India. It continues to sponsor terrorism against India. And clearly, Pakistan is in the dock. And in the recent past, we have seen that even
also,
at the
Sunil
United
ji,
Nations,
walk our viewers through all the confessions that have been made point by point by the captured terrorists. We have it all on camera.
Well, Cheti has clearly said that he was trained in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province of Pakistan, and there are terror training camps. Terrorists are being trained, and they are being brainwashed. They are being asked to wage jihad against India. So Pakistan hasn't stopped anti-India terror activities. It has clearly, you know, tried to foment trouble in Jammu and Kashmir for last three decades. And time and again, terrorists have come out. He's not the first terrorist who has made this confession. In the past also, we have seen that there have been terrorists who have made confessions, who have nailed Islamabad's role. And this is the latest in that series. That how a terrorist was trained by Pakistan Army and ISI. Because time and again, Cheti, we see that Pakistan at the international forum says that it's a victim of terrorism itself, that it is that it is innocent, its agencies are not involved in any kind of terror activities, and at the international forum Pakistan talks about peace and tranquility, but this is the real face of Pakistan which has been exposed by one of their own.
Absolutely. He also gone on to say, provoked by the Pakistani army against India, the Pakistani terrorist stands to be captured. This is his confession that is coming in, proof of Pakistani army's nefarious design right here. It's an India Today exclusive that we're bringing to you at this point of time. His confession right there on camera. We'll play that out for you as well. Sunilji, how strategic is this? Of course, it's a win for the security forces. But how strategic would this be for the Indian intelligence agencies too?
Well, Chetty, it's a big catch because he was the one who was trained at a terror camp in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province of Pakistan. He's going to give out details of the kind of training that is given to the terrorists in Pakistan, and that how Pakistan army officials and ISI officials are involved in training terrorists. So it's going to strengthen the hands of the intelligence agencies. It's going to strengthen the hands of the Indian security establishment, and they are going to get proof of Pakistan's involvement in terror activities. And at the international forum also, the government can tell it to the international community that see how Pakistan is involved.
Yes, the international, the world is watching. The world is watching this confession of the terrorist who has clearly gone on to nail Pakistan's nefarious designs. His confession is right there for the world to see on camera, and hence it's a big win for the Indian Army and for the intelligence to get the right kind of inputs as well from this particular terrorist. And as you rightly explained, it's rather very strategic for the Indian intelligence too. It's a big win coming in right there with this particular confession being made by the terrorist who was captured live by the Indian Army. Let me take this across now to Gaurav Sawant. Gaurav, explain to us exactly how the terrorists, including the captured terrorist Ali Babar, entered into the Indian territory. Over to you.
So this is the map of the area where this terrorist, Pakistani terrorist Ali Babar Patra, son of late Muhammad Hanif, is 19 years old. He's from Okara in Pakistan's Punjab province. This is where this terrorist was arrested. So understand the lay of the land first. This is the international border. That's Lahore, Amritsar. Travel up, that's Sialkot. This is Jammu. Then this is where the line of control is. And now along the Pir Panjal ranges, let's come to Kashmir. And now let me bring you here. So Okara is where this terrorist was born. He underwent training here at Markaz-e-Khyber. This is in Gadi Habibullah. This was in January 2019, 21-day training. Then in 2021, from 13th to 20th, a refresher course. And then on the 21st of April, he moved to Halan Shumali. So let's now, this is the route that the terrorist took. This is the line of control. Now, from what sources tell in India Today, this is where they crossed Bagh. This is where they were coming in. And this is the Halan Shumali debt. Again, they stayed at this debt on the 23rd of April. They stayed here for 4 months, underwent certain trainings. Now, when you learn about the matrix sheet, this is when you're learning about map reading, technical course, communication, GPS, equipment, all of that this learned. 16th of September, six terrorists were launched. This is the launch pad. This is the line of control. And again, you can look at the difference. This is where Uri is. So close to Uri at the LC, these terrorists infiltrated. So 16 September, they left. 18 September, they reached the green patch. They were spotted, intercepted by a patrol of the Indian Army. Four terrorists, they ran back. Two terrorists succeeded in crossing over, Ali Babar Patra and Atirur Rahman, alias Kari Anas. Now, this is where the encounter took place on the 26th of September. Ali Babar surrendered and Kari Anas was killed. So now you understand the lay of the land. Now, look at this map. High mountains, densely forested area, extremely difficult to see where people are infiltrating from. So while this place is fenced, incidentally, this is also the area where terrorists 5 years ago, when they attacked the army location here at Uri, they had infiltrated through this route. That time they succeeded, but subsequently the Indian Army took a number of very effective countermeasures, including ambushes in the forested area and in the nalas. And this is where the terrorists were intercepted, neutralized and arrested. The terrorist who's been arrested will have a gold mine of information in terms of their training, launch pads and the role of Pakistan Army.
All right, Gaurav, thank you for that input right there. That was Gaurav Sawant joining us from the newsroom. A sinister Pakistan terror plot has been busted by the Indian Army in Uri. Indian Army has captured a Pakistani terrorist and killed another during infiltration bid. The terrorist has been identified as 19-year-old Babar, who belongs to the Lashkar-e-Taiba and hails from Okara in Pakistan. 7 terrorists have been killed in the Uri sector in the last 7 days. Abhishek Palla with this ground report.
This is the face of Pakistan treachery. A 19-year-old terrorist captured by our army in Uri, who has been identified as Ali Babar Patra. A member of LET, a resident of Okara district in Pakistan. After a 3-week terror training in Gadi Habibullah, Pakistan, Ali Babar was given the responsibility to drop armed supplies across the border and unleash terror in India.
He has admitted that he is a member of Lashkar-e-Taiba. He has revealed that he underwent a 3-week course in 2019 at Khyber Camp, Gadi Habibullah, Muzaffarabad. That's the location of his training camp that he has revealed.
On the night of September 18th, taking advantage of darkness, uneven grounds, dense forest and bad weather, 6 terrorists of LET, including Ali Babar, tried to cross the border. The infiltration bid was intercepted by our alert security forces. Soon, a gun battle began and 4 terrorists retreated to Pakistan. But Ali Babar and his aide managed to enter India.
The infiltration group was of a strength of 6 personnel. 2 of these infiltrators had come across the fence, while 4 were on the other side of the fence. After the firefight, these 4 terrorists who were on the Pakistani side of the fence, they took advantage of dense foliage and darkness and retreated towards the Pakistani side.
Patrol parties hunted them down and established contact with the 2 terrorists on September 25th, leading to a fierce encounter. 33-year-old Pakistan terrorist Atiqur Rahman was killed while teenager Ali Babar begged for his life and was captured alive.
Second terrorist pleaded us for his life. Even though he has fired on us a number of times in the contact, we accepted his surrender and handled him humanely.
A huge cache of arms and ammunition were also recovered from the terrorist, exposing Pakistan's nefarious terror designs. 7 AK-style rifles, 9 pistols, and several hand grenades were recovered.
This is the Salamabad Nala from where the infiltrators had come in. It's significant to note that this is the same route that the infiltrators have taken that they took 5 years back when in 2016 a deadly attack on the Uri camp took place, killing 17 Indian soldiers.
This big boost for our forces came on the 5th anniversary of the surgical strikes on Pakistan terror camps. Since September 18th, the anniversary of Uri terror attacks, in a desperate bid, Pakistani terrorists backed by their army have attempted various infiltration bids in Uri sector, only to get a befitting reply from our army.
In last 7 days, 7 terrorists have been neutralized and 1 terrorist has been apprehended, and 5 of these neutralizations have taken place along the line of control.
India's counterinsurgency operations launched in Uri have stopped some major terror attacks, but security forces are still maintaining a very strict vigil to thwart Pakistan's terror module.
It is clear that due to the low recruitment of terrorists within Kashmir, Pakistan is getting desperate and making sure that they can send as many terrorists from Pakistan in a short time from now. But the Indian Army has been thwarting all their attempts. With camera person Roof in Uri, Abhishek Bhalla, Find Your Today.